Hello everyone, this is Professor Mihir Shah once again with another video. In this video we are going to learn basically what is window dressing. So let us see what does this window dressing mean in auditing.
Tell me one thing, I hope everyone of you all, everyone of you all must have gone to, you know, visit any mall, let's say Phoenix or in Orbit or any other malls available in India. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now take an example. If you all are moving in a mall, Okay. And on one of the sides, okay, on the very left side, there is a window showcase where you have a lot of mannequins. Okay, you have a mannequins with, very well dressed up. Let's say that particular mannequin is wearing a jeans and a t-shirt or a shirt. The color of the jeans is, let's say, yellow, and the shirt is, let's say, red, bright red. On the mannequin, it is looking amazing. Looking at the mannequin, you went into the shop and you all purchased those same outfit. You all came home and you all wore the same outfit. But now on the mannequin, it was looking amazing. But when you all wore it, it was the worst thing you could have done, okay, in your life. Has any one of you all come across that situation ever? Or seen this kind of situation ever?
Yes, sir. Seen this situation.
Seen. Okay. We are, a little bit smart because commerce people are a little smart. They first check it carefully. Whenever the cost come into the picture, first we literally check it. But thereafter only we buy it. But other department. Okay. You don't know too much about cost or, to account or something. So let's say they bought. Mannequin made was looking very well, but when you wore it, it was pathetic. What is the reason behind this? Why was it looking very well here, but when you wore it, it was something completely different? Why is this thing happening? Why does this thing happen? Okay. The simple reason is, it is called window shopping, if I'm not wrong. Window shopping is what? On the showcase, whatever you see, you just buy that. But people forget that this particular mannequin, has been given those clothes due to some reason. Okay, there are specific lightings over it, if I'm not wrong.
Yes, sir.
There is a particular ambience. They give you a particular background, and on that, the mannequin has been placed. Okay, the same thing is not in reality. So now to sum it up, okay, not to, put this picture in one thing, can I say that the company X, let's say this is a company X. Company X, the products were horrible. Okay, company X had horrible products, but it wanted to sell that products. So in order the company sell the product, the company did some fake publicity of the product. Okay, it made a situation such that it looks very good, but in reality, the products were very bad. Okay, so to sum it up in a very small gist, okay, we can say that in reality, the products were very bad, but the company showed a very good picture of that product. Yes or no? To summarize this example, can I say that the products were very bad, but the company showed a very good picture of those products? Can I say in that way?
Yes.
Okay, that's it. Window dressing ka matlab wahi hai. The picture, the company is in a very bad position. The company is in crisis, but the company does not want to show that to its shareholders. So it is doing window dressing. window dressing means books, showing books of account attractively. It means showing a wrong picture. Company is in losses, but company is showing that we are earning huge profits. That is called window dressing. Actual picture kuch aur hai, but the company is showing something else. Why does a company does window dressing? Number one, to mislead the investors and lenders. Let's say company wants a loan. Company is in huge debt. Company is in huge losses. Will anyone give you loan?
No.
No, sir.
Will any investor invest into your company?
Not at all.
Okay. Now, the moment you don't have money, you cannot even come out of those losses. If you don't have money, you cannot come out of the losses also. So, to attract the investor, to get the loan, okay, the company goes into window dressing. So, it manipulates it, you know, its accounts in such a way that it automatically shows a very good picture of the company. The moment the picture is good, investors will invest, lenders will give. That is the first objective. Second, it hides losses. To hide my losses, I don't want to show losses. Okay, because the moment a company shows losses, it shows that the management is inefficient. Investors won't invest. That will be again another loss for the company. Third, favorable terms and conditions. If a company requires favorable terms and conditions from the lenders and investors, then it should have good profit-making company. So in order to have good favorable terms and conditions, the company shows window dressing. Take the best example, Vijay Mallya. Everyone knows about him?
Yes.
What is the amount of fraud which he has done? Oh, competent BBI people, tell me kitna amount ka loss kiya hai.
The amount to nahi maata, he's done a huge loss.
Okay, it is approximately 8,000 to 9,000 CR. Okay, 8,000 crore or 9,000 crore, one of them. Now see, why I'm telling that example, why window dressing? He had obtained that loan by giving a security of his planes. Okay, whatever flights, whatever aeroplane that he had given the security of those planes, because of which he got that loan. But the problem was that those were fake statements. The planes which he have are already on loan. But when he made the financial statement, he stated that all the planes are debt-free and they are all belonging to him. That is called again an example of window dressing. Picture kuch aur tha. The planes were already on a loan, and on that loan plane pay he took another loan. That is the reality of the, you know, the scenario. But he showed that he is the loan owner of all the planes. He has bought them with his own money. But it is not that way. That was window dressing. In order to get, you know, he wanted money. In order to mislead them, he did window dressing. He showed everything. Hey, I'm in good profit. I have a lot of money, a lot of planes. He took the loan, and then he, with that same loan money, when his same flight, he went off India and he's never coming back again. So that is again an example of window dressing. Did everyone now get somewhat, you know, an idea about window dressing? Kya hota hai?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I hope this should clear your doubt on window dressing. At least window dressing, what it is. Okay. Last, it is overvaluation of goodwill. You're into complete debt, but because you show good profit, you are overvaluing your goodwill. Okay, you are showing you are a very reputed business, reputed organization. Now, can anyone tell me how can you do a window dressing? Let's say you all are board of directors of the company. Company is going into complete losses. Can you all tell me how can you all do window dressing?
So by overstating the asset and understating the liability.
Wow, कहाँ से Google किया?
So खुद से बोला मैंने सच में.
that's great, perfect. Whatever she has done said is perfect. Okay, how window dressing is done? Okay, it can be done. Number one, overstatement of assets. I will state my asset on a higher side. As I bought one computer of 20,000, I will say I bought one computer for 80,000. I overstated my asset. The moment I increase the value of my assets, okay, eventually my capital is also increasing. I'm seeing a very good picture. Okay, I'm doing window dressing. Second, understatement of liabilities. When I'm increasing my asset, on the other hand, I'm decreasing my liabilities. So I'm showing that my company is in a very good position. Other than that, how can I do window dressing? These are two perfect points. There are two more points. You can try anyone. One, to chalo asset increase kya, liability decrease kya. What about P&L statement? How can you window dress there?
Overstatement of income.
Yeah, increase your income and
show less
statement of expense.
Exactly. Very simple. See, if you'll understand the concept, to write a short note of 1.5 pages is very simple. Okay, now suppose in this, if you have to elaborate, first you would have written overstatement of asset, then explain in a line. Overstatement means increasing the value of asset. Example, give an example. Mr. X, okay, purchased computers of 50,000, overstated by showing it rupees 5 lakhs. Okay, aram se you can fit up the answers and you don't have to, you know, mug up or buy out the answer. Just need to understand that. Perfect. Overstatement of incomes and revenue, and secondly and lastly, understatement of expense. If you increase your income, decrease your expense, your profit increases. If you increase your asset, decrease your liability, your net worth increases. So in that case, you're showing a very wrong picture of your business, which is not the actual one. That is known as window dressing. So just have a look at it and let me know if anyone have any doubt. If you all understood window dressing, then I'll go ahead. If you all have doubt, I will clear it.
So if any company does this and if the auditor comes to know, then any which ways the company will go, like it will shut
away. Who comes to know, you said?
The auditor or any
one thing. Let me first say who is an auditor. Okay, first, that is the most important thing first. Auditor is considered only to be a watchdog. Okay, there is this one statement with the ICAI has mentioned. Auditor is a watchdog and not a bloodhound. Okay, they have given this particular phrase. Auditor is only the auditor is only considered to be a watchdog. He will only look into your errors and fraud. It will not disclose it to anyone else. He will only tell the management ki ye galat hai. After that, it is the duty of the management to publish it or not. Okay, so auditor is just a watchdog. It will only tell you. It won't attack you. The auditor is only a watchdog but not a bloodhound. Okay, bloodhounds are carnivores. Okay, they directly go and kill your predators. So they are telling you that auditors will never do that. Okay, there are some rules. Okay, auditor is only said to be a watchdog in the sense it will only give an opinion, and that also he'll only give an opinion to the management who is going to pay him. He will never disclose it anywhere else. And later on also, if by any other sources the company comes to know, anyone comes to know about it and he files a complaint over it, the auditor will never be arrested.
So they will not ask the auditor.
They will ask, but the auditor, see, again, that is what I'm telling. There was a big scam. Satyam, if you all remember, Satyam Info Technology, there is this company called us, or there was a company called Satyam. It is taken over by Mahindra now. So what happened in that case was, the CEO of that company recorded 5,000 employee ka salary, bogus salary, okay, bogus salary of 5,000 employees. And that amount used to be transferred to his personal account. So when the fraud came into picture, when the government came about to know about it, and there was, you know, case launched over it, chartered accountants from PwC, that is near Bandra, West Talao, from there the chartered accountants were there. So they were questioned, didn't you all come across these 5,000 bogus, you know, people? There were no 5,000 people, and he was taking salary. The salary came approximately to around 5,000 crores, okay? So the chartered accountants were questioned, why you all didn't come across this error of fraud? Chartered accountants were very simple. They have very simple answer to give. We only audit the documents which are provided by the management. We don't go and call each and every employee. So as per the auditor, he's only a watchdog. Whatever the management will provide, he will look at it and he will make a report over that. Got it?
Yes.
So auditor ko koi issue nahi rehta. Auditor ko jo dikhai ke wo usi ke upar report bana ke he will give it. He will just give a report over that particular stuff which you have provided. So that's why it's clear that the auditor is a watchdog but not a bloodhound. He only sees into whatever, and he never comes into any trouble. If any case is also on him, it's very simple. The management gave me those documents. On those documents, I have prepared the audit report.
Okay, sir.
Samjha? So auditor ko issue nahi rehta. And but if the outsider gives a complaint, then the company can be come into an issue. Okay, company ko issue ho sakta hai. The management can be arrested, but auditor has nothing to do with that.
Okay.
Samjha? Chalo, everyone understood window dressing?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it should be now clear ki if company has a bad position but it is showing a good position, then it is called window dressing.